गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। चिल्ड्रन, मॉर्निंग मैम। टेल मी वन थिंग, आर यू फेसिंग सम काइंड ऑफ ट्रबल विद ज़ूम दीस डेज? इज इट लैगिंग अ लॉट?
यस मैम।
नो मैम।
आई डोंट नो व्हाई आई एम मीटिंग गेट स्टार्टेड आफ्टर 2-3 मिनट्स
मैम।
Keep
now one day my meetings were not starting for 10 minutes.
God knows what is the problem. So frustrating it is.
Ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, my mobile battery is low, ma'am. That's why ma'am, I have joined with my mother's mobile.
Acha, okay, beta. All right. Now, everyone, we were doing chapter number 5, Say Noel, right?
Ma'am, we completed page number 58.
We completed page number 58. Yes, we completed it. Now, coming on to the ER ending words with some change. Okay, changes in some of the ER ending verbs. Now, we've studied the verbs like parler, chanter, such simple words. So what happens is, just a second, children, I'll just change my setting a little. Yes. Now, suppose there's a verb like ashiter. The verb in infinitive form does not have any accent. But when we conjugate it, it gets accent grave on it. Jashet. And the pronunciation also changes. It becomes jashet. Otherwise, it is ashiter. With je, tu, il, and el. We always put accent, but with nu and vu, it is ashton, ashte. There the pronunciation is not asheton or ashete. It's ashton or ashte. No ashte. Accent. Yes. And again with ils, ells, ilzashet, elzashet. Okay. So you have to remember this thing. Then when we come on to kmoser, with everything, with all subject pronouns, it is the same. But when we talk about nu, so what we do, we put sidel in kmoson, c-o-n-s. Why? Because c-o sound is what? Ko, like kmo. Okay. To give its a sound, only in case of nu, we put this sidel. Otherwise,
okay,
wherever we have ce, ce is pronounced as sa only. We have sa sound only. But with co, it becomes ko. So we put sidel over there. Then, coming on to the next verb, that is apeler. Now, from day one, you have studied apeler, yamapel, tyutapel, and this verb in various forms. Now, when we talk about the infinitive form of the verb, it is, see, look at the spellings, A-P-P-E-L-E-R. But when we conjugate it, what it becomes? It takes double L. That is why we say jappel or jamapel, double L-E. Isn't it? With all yes, subject but pronouns, it's double L except for nu and vu. It's aple, aplon. Yes? Only in these yes, two ma'am. Cases, we have a single L. Then, coming on to the next verb, that is jeter. Jeter is to throw. Again, here we have double T everywhere. Like in apeler, we make it double L. In jeter, we make it double T. Except for nu and vu. So all these four verbs, you're going to write them in the copy. click picture and send it on the class group. And all of you, please open your cameras also. Start doing the work.
Ma'am, we have to write the words which you told. Ashatair, Commissaire, Aplair or Shatair.
Yes. In the notebook, you have to write the conjugation of all these four verbs.
Okay, ma'am.
Children, we've already written the conjugation of fair, right? The verb fair.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
I'm sent on the group.
Okay, beta.
मैम सेंट
ओके बेटा क्लास 8th A एंड 8th B नो वन हैज सेंट टिल नाउ
मैम सेंट मैम सेंट
Anyone has sent from class 8th A or 8th B? Anvi and Dhruv Kumar and Aradhe. Beta, you are from A and B sections.
Ma'am, I'm sending.
What about the other two? Dhruv, Aradhe?
I'm not sending.
Anji?
Ma'am, sending.
Sending. Okay, now coming on to the next part, we've already done fair work, which has different uses. Fair means to make, to do, and it is used for different activities also. Like, for example, if I have to say I do skiing or I ski, in English we simply say I ski, he skis. But in French, how do we say? We say, fait, sorry, faire Dusky. The expression goes fair Dusky or fair due piano. To play a piano, it's fair due piano. Even for days, to tell the weather, I've told you it is fair. Il fait beau, il fait chaud, il fait froid, like that. So fair has got many uses. We've already done the conjugation of fair verb. Now let's come on to the next page on 60 and see. Expressions avec fair. Elle fait un gâteau. What does it mean?
She makes a cake.
She makes a cake.
Elle fait du ski.
She do ski.
She do skiing.
She skis. Okay, in English, what will say? She skis. Elle fait ses devoirs.
She.
Yes, she does.
She's doing homework.
She does the homework.
Yes, she does her homework. Like that. Because it is given ses devoirs. Then, il fait jour. What is il fait jour? It is day. Jaise hum kehte hain, abhi to din ho raha hai. It is day. It's daytime. Il fait nuit.
It's the night.
It is night. Then,
night.
Il fait chaud.
It is hot.
It is hot.
Il fait froid.
It is cold.
It is cold. Il fait une promenade. She is simple. She is walking. Okay, she is walking. Elle fait une promenade. Now,
okay, ma'am.
Il fait froid is thand ho rahi hai. It is cold. But if you want to say, I am feeling cold or I have cold, what do you say? J'ai froid. I have cold, and have cold here it means I am feeling cold. Okay, j'ai froid. I am feeling cold. J'ai chaud. I am feeling hot. So all these expressions with fair verb, just write them down in the copy. Do it in the
copy along with the translation.
Beta, now that's your choice. If you find it is a little difficult, you must write it, because sometimes we forget what it means. So just write down the English translation.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of the last sentence?
Elle fait une promenade. She is walking, or she takes a walk.
Okay, ma'am.
I'm done.
Send it, beta.
Okay, ma'am.
Mom, I have sent.
Okay, children, I'm just going through your work. It's okay, she's keys.
Ma'am sent.
What is the spelling of skis, children? Yes, what is
skis?
No,
skies.
No, beta. It is just skis. Eighth A and B, your work is still awaited. Okay, Anvi has sent, Avni has sent.
Ma'am, Anvi only.
Okay, children, now moving on to the next part, which is very important also in framing sentences. We have learned making sentences into negative, right? Je parle français, je ne parle pas français. These are simple negative sentences. But now there are sentences that change in the negative form. Like, for example, if I ask you, do you have a pen? So how would you reply? No, ma'am, I don't have any pen, right? You don't say, I don't have a pen. Yes, what do you say? I don't have any pen, right? In some of the cases where we use have verb, the negative sentences take up any in the end. Do you have a cake? No, I don't have any cake. Do you have French book? I don't have any French book. Yes? So how do we use it? See, on page number 61, elle a un stylo. Elle n'a pas Now we will not write she doesn't have a pen. We'll write she doesn't have any pen. El napa the stilo. The here in between tells that it stands for any. Yes? El napa the stilo. Then el a de stilo. She has pens. El napa the stilo. Again in plural, it is going to be the only. In both the cases, it's going to be the. See, look up here. El a stilo. So what it becomes? El napa the stilo. She does not have any pen. She has pens if it is de stilo. So again, el napa the stilo. Correct? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Look at the fifth sentence. Il y a un étudiant. There is a student. There is no student. Or there is not any student. Is there a student outside? No, there is no student outside. Or there is not any student outside. So, il n'y a pas d'étudiant. With vowels, how we use? We use it in the similar way. So, just write down these five examples with avoir verb. For now, just write the sentences, how they come with avoir verb.
Ma'am, send.
Ma'am sent.
Okay, beta. All of you send this work. Then we'll see. After receiving everyone's work, if there'll be time left, we'll move on to the next thing. Otherwise, we won't. This will be all for today. HC, only two students have sent it. Only Angel and Bhavya have sent. No one else has. Children, have you done it?
Yes, ma'am. Sent.
Yes, Bhavya, you have sent. Ridhima, you have sent.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have also sent.
Okay, beta. Okay. So that is, this is all for today. Now, when we'll meet next week, we are going to do then. Okay. Those who have done can leave. Those who've not, please send it to me positively. Don't let the work be undone.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, beta.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. You're welcome.